हेलो एंड वेलकम टू डेली बाइट्स. टुडे इज़ जून 25th, एपिसोड 39, फ्राइडे. लेट्स सी हाउ द मार्केट डिड. द मार्केट्स ओपन्ड अप, गैप अप ऑन बोथ निफ्टी एंड बैंक निफ्टी. द इंडाइसेस वर मोस्टली गोइंग अप थ्रू द डे. ऑल्दो द फर्स्ट आवर वॉज अ बिट टेंटेटिव, बट मोर आफ्टर दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द सेक्टर्स टुक अ लीड एंड द मार्केट्स वर गोइंग अप. Reliance was the one major stock which was going against the trend, and it continued yesterday's fall that it saw after the AGM, and into today it was down at 2.5% at one point in the day. Nifty Next 50, CNX 200, CNX 500 all went up about 0.5%. So it was a pretty even day for all the indices put together. In terms of the sectoral index indices, PSU banks, even private banks, metals were heavily in the lead. Auto stocks were doing well. Some pharma stocks were doing well. FMCG took a break today, but more or less a reasonably broad-based gains for the day and for the week. Also now, most of the losses of the previous days have been wiped out. In terms of the weekend investing, small case performances. MI30 had a big day, 1.8% up. NNF10 was up 1.3%. MI25, MIMT all had reasonably a good day. ATH, which had a very nice gains in the morning, gave up most of the gains by evening, but still closed marginally in the green. On a weekly basis, ATH has done very well. It's up almost 5%. MI30 has done very well, 3.5%. Others have done about 2%. MIMT all cap has been a bit slow recently. On the monthly as well as on the financial, everything looks reasonably good. So there are no worries on this front as of now. In terms of our topic for the day, yesterday, if you recall, we had discussed about the advantages of having a long-term view onto the market and for holding on to our strategy for the long term, and how the probability keeps increasing as your probability of winning keeps increasing as your time in the market goes up. It does not really mean that you can just sit in the market and for as long as you want and you will get gains, but your underlying strategy needs to be a winning one also. So when we are looking at this from an index perspective, you know, trying to invest into the index and then sitting for long, then yes, your underlying strategy itself is robust, that it will continue to be, you know, rebalanced every 6 months. The index is like a momentum portfolio. So they will take away the laggards, bring in the new winners. And so the underlying strategy itself has been taken care of, and now you only have to sit on it. So as we saw yesterday, if you sit on it long enough, more than 5 years, the probability of your winning becomes very, very high. And as I promised yesterday, we were going to see how the same probability changes when we do SIPs or rupee cost averaging versus lump sum CAGR that we saw yesterday. So let's dive right in. Let's first look at the 1 year chart. Let me just figure out where am I on the okay. So we are here on 1 year. Yesterday we saw a lump sum chart. So these are basically going from December 95 down to December 20th. 25 years of data, and we saw the CAGRs of lump sum returns. Even in lump sum returns, you are seeing that, you know, the deep red is occasional, you know, once every few years only. So if you actually see that a red year is actually a good way of jumping into the market, you find a red year, jump in. The next year to be green is high probability. Just once you had a double digit repeating in 2 years, otherwise every time you had a double digit loss, the next year was fantastic, right? So this itself is a strategy. jump in whenever you have a down year. Anyhow, so coming back to SIPs, so we've done, 1 year of SIPs. So what you can see is when you do 1 year of SIP, the number of times that you may lose, and these are XIRR calculations. We did a video on XIRR. If you wish to go and see the daily bite on that, an explainer was done on XIRR versus the CAGR, and you can see that in various years you had XIRR being negative, and in some of them even deeper than the CAGRs, right? So this is happening because 1 year is not sufficient period for the SIP to really show its impact, right? So probability of gain is same, 72% here, 72% here, but the average is slightly more. So some of the years, like last year, the CAGR was 15%, but the XIRR was 57%. So this average could have been skewed by some of these readings also. Now let's go and see what happens over 3 years. We saw yesterday that over 3 years, there was 1 3-year period which had a minus 10% CAGR, and virtually there was no other 3-year period which was really down. This minus 1% also in December 98. However, when we do the SIP, in terms of 3-year SIP XIRR returns, we find that there are several years which are negative. And in fact, December 8, 3 years ending December 8, was minus 17% for the SIP XIRR. So while on many 3-year periods like 2003, 2004, 2005, the XIRR was fantastic, but on a down year like 2008, the XIRR for 3 years leading to this was very negative. Again, the probability of gain remained high in CAGR versus the probability of gain was lower at 78% in SIPs. The average gain, however, was still more in SIPs versus the CAGR. So this was the finding in 3 years of data. Now let's look at 5 years of data. So this is rolling returns, 5 years. So when I'm saying December 2000, it means 95 to 2000, 5 years of CAGR was 7%. If you did SIP, it would have been 6% XIRR. So here also you are seeing that in many of the years, the XIRR was much, much higher. In some years, of course, in the down, which was majorly down years included in those five, the XIRR was very poor at 2%. But the probability of your being in green was reasonably similar, 95% here and 90% here, and the average returns were again higher in SIPs. So what this is suggesting is that as we are going higher and higher in terms of the time frame, the SIP probability is improving, and the average anyways is doing better than the CAGR returns. Now let's look at 7 years. So 7 years returns, we are seeing that in CAGR there was no 7 year period which was in loss. So that itself is a very good stat to consider, that in any 7 year period in the last 25 years there was no loss. Of course, there were some years where you had the gains were little, 3 to 4% CAGR over 7 years is very difficult to digest. However, in SIPs, there were 95% success probability versus 100% in CAGR. But again, average returns were 14% in SIP versus 13%. Here also, in series of very good years like 2003 to 2007, while CAGR remained between 10% and 25%, the XIRR went up to as high as 37%. And in recent years, it has been very similar to CAGR returns of low teens here as well. The last chart that we have here is for 10 years of CAGR. So the ideal period for staying in the market is 5 years and more, and ideally 7 years to 10 years. So here we see, as we saw yesterday also, in CAGR returns, barring one or two instances, the returns were in double digits, the 100% probability of gain, and average returns were 13%. When we are doing SIPs for 10 years, we are seeing that this low single digit is only till it has come only till 8% once, and there was 1 9%. Otherwise, this is also mostly double digit returns, and the average, and again 100% success rate in both, and the average return is slightly more than the CAGR. So in all these five studies, 1 year, 3 year, 5 year, 7 year, 10 years, what we are seeing is that the XIRR returns on SIPs is better than the CAGR. The probability of having gains over that period for few tests has been lower than CAGR, but 7 years and 10 years, the probability has been same, and the average is also more. So what one can conclude from these preliminary sort of studies is that SIP is a robust mechanism for long-term growth of your portfolio. And most of us are working in jobs or have limited amounts to save and invest occasionally or monthly. And hence, SIP is, even if you don't want to choose it, by choice, by necessity, that is the only vehicle that we have. Or what we can do alternatively is to, accumulate money and look for opportunistic entries into the market. As and when we find a hugely negative year, we go lump sum in those years, which is very difficult to do actually. So SIPs is a very good alternative. And this, mind you, are the returns and the probability of success on index. So what we are saying is that there can be many strategies which are doing much better than the index. So we need not limit our, growth at the index level only. And I'm sorry to say, but many star fund managers are not able to beat the index also. So you must find strategies where your strategy is able to beat the index, and then if you are sipping on it, have a time frame of 5, 7, 10 years, and there is no way that you will not make money and not do well. So with these limited sort of insights, I want to end today's Daily Bite, and I want to thank you for watching these Daily Bites and sending me your comments. Have a great weekend, and I'll see you in another video next week. Bye.